Hello, I'm back, and welcome once again to another easy lesson or review or tutorial by MBAbullshit.com. So today, or this time, our topic will be on or about CAPM, or the Capital Asset Pricing Model in the field of finance or financial management. Management sounds scary and complicated, but don't worry, this is just MBA bullshit, and we can cut through the bullshit and you can see how easy and simple it actually is. Okay, so just remember, you can always come here whether you're a business student in college, BBA or MBA, or if you're an executive who just wants to learn because you don't have time for an MBA, or because you need a refresher from your previous MBA, or if you're a non-business moron like me before, and maybe you're an artist or a creative person or a doctor and you just want to learn the concepts of MBA quickly and easily, you can always go to MBAbullshit.com. For lots of free videos. Okay, so now let's go to the capital asset pricing model. Now, most professors will explain the capital asset pricing model, or CAPM, as a formula which looks like this. Now, I know that this formula over here can look very scary and intimidating, but please do not panic, because this is actually very simple when I show you step by step how easy it actually is. Okay, so don't worry about it. But in order to allow you to understand it well, I want you to first remove this complicated bullshit from your brain right now, temporarily. We'll get back to it later. Remove it from your brain, don't panic, and I just want you to look and focus. I just want you to focus on this other thing I'm going to show you now, okay? You're going to see it's not complicated at all. So I'm going to start by telling you a story, and in the story, I'm going to give you a choice. Let's say I offered you a risk-free investment. Okay, it was an investment, or it's an opportunity for you to earn money by putting your money in my bank. You have a deposit account in my bank, and my bank is guaranteed by the government, and so therefore it is risk-free, zero risk. Okay, for sure the bank will not collapse like what happened in the recent economic crisis. In this case, you are 100% sure that the bank would not collapse. Okay? And you have the opportunity, you have the offer to deposit your money in this bank, and the bank will give you an interest of 2%. Okay? So the 2% here is what we call the risk-free rate. Okay? So let's just say that you can put your money in my bank. My bank has no risk, and you can earn 2% interest, or 2% income, or 2% profit on your money by depositing that money with this bank. And then I give you a second choice, okay? I give you a second choice with an investment which has medium risk, okay? And for this example, let's just say that the United States stock market, the general stock market, has medium risk. So the bank here, the bank deposit, has no risk or zero risk, and the US general stock market has medium risk, which is also called systematic risk. Now, don't worry so much about the systematic risk here. This is just MBA bullshit, And for now, I just want, let's just use the word medium risk, and we can get back to the systematic risk later. Now, it's called systematic risk because it represents the risk of a certain system which is usually used, such as the United States stock market. Okay? But if you don't understand what I just said, don't worry about it. Just forget it for now. For now, we'll just say it's medium risk. Now, what if I also offered you, so I offered you a risk-free investment, a zero-risk investment or deposit earning 2%, and I also offered you a medium-risk investment. And this medium-risk investment would earn you also 2%. Okay? It would also earn you 2%. So, if you had to choose between this investment here or this investment here, which one would you choose? Which one? They earn the same amount, but this one has higher risk than this. Well, if you have at least some intelligence, then for sure you would choose, you would choose this investment and not this one. Why? Because in this investment, you earn 2%, but you have no risk. In this investment, you also earn the same small profit of 2%, or you expect to earn the same small profit of 2%, but you have even higher risk compared to this one over here. So of course, it makes much better sense to put your money here in the no-risk investment. Okay? So let me ask you, let's say I was a stockbroker in the United States who trades stocks in the United States, and I want to convince you to move your money away from here and instead put your money here. How would I do that if I'm only giving you 2%? Well, of course, the normal way would be for me to try and offer you more than 2%. And I'd try to offer you extra money, extra profit, or an extra percentage here. That way, it will be worth it for you to move your money from here to here. Because now, you're earning more profit in order to pay you for the extra risk. Okay? So, for this example, let's just say I offered you an extra 6%. Okay? So I offered you an extra 6% return or an extra 6% profit on your money to place your money here instead of here. Okay? So now, these two investments have equal attractiveness. Okay, let's just call it equal attractiveness. Because here, you only earn 2%, but you've got no risk. Here, you earn 2% plus 6%, but you have medium risk. And medium risk is more than no risk. So now, these two choices should have equal attractiveness.